was called for a false serve. He seemed to lose his focus a little bit, so it can definitely interfere. This should be an outstanding match. Kasumi to serve. Not a bad first rally to start this best of seven match. Now, just to let you know, these two have played together 14 times on the world tour, starting in 2007, so it's been a decade of rivalry between these two. Although Kasumi Ishikawa was 14 years old at that point. Feng Tianwei, a mere 20. That was right when Feng Tianwei started playing in Singapore, I believe. That was the under 21 women's singles quarterfinals in China, where Feng Tianwei grew up playing before she moved to Japan. And at 18 years old, spent 2 years in Japan and then moved to Singapore, and since 20 has been doing outstandingly well for Singapore, even voted athlete of the year in Singapore in the past. Excellent backhand, staying loose. So out of those 14 encounters, 9 of them have been won by Feng Tianwei, the top seed in this tournament. Although the last 2 have been won by Kasumi Ishikawa, and the last time they played was at the Olympic Games. It was a 3-0 victory for Kasumi. Little bit of side spin playing the middle of the table. Feng Tianwei did this very effectively yesterday. Again, Feng Tianwei, the only player who could beat Minami Ando. Ando winning the under 21 women's singles title. Also beating Mima Ito at the national championships in Japan. Beat Yu Meng Yu while she was here in this tournament in the women's singles. The sidekick and teammate of Feng Tianwei. Has been a very big part of Singapore's success with Feng Tianwei in recent years, including last year in Malaysia at the Team World Championships, the World Team Championships. Trying to come right back in after the lob. The backhand sort of last resort defense, and then a quick turn for the forehand slap. Difficult when you're that far back from the table and it's played right into the middle. Thinking about the fact that Kasumi won 3-0 in their last encounter, still, this match could go either way. Well played serve, half long. Well, both of these players have a lot of feeling. Kasumi Ishikawa, I would say, has a wider variety of serves that she can pull out. Earns an off, I'd say a great opportunity after that down the line forehand, but still Feng Tianwei chasing the ball, keeps it low, keeps it back. Quality shot, even though she's a little bit out of position, keeps the pressure on Ishikawa. So in case you weren't tuning in yesterday, Feng Tianwei's first sport was not table tennis. It was figure skating. Her father asked her to try figure skating. She tried it for 3 days, cried every day, didn't like it. Her mom, who was a hobby player, said, "What about table tennis?"
6-0.
And as a parent looking back, seeing your daughter at 30 years having one of the most illustrious careers in women's table tennis, it's quite interesting to see that decision. Sort of a high five to dad, or maybe a ha-ha, told you so. Wonder how many figure skaters played table tennis first.
Net 6-0.
So Ishikawa quickly ties it back up. 3 out of the last 4 points.
7-6.
And that's some of the unpredictability I was talking about with Kasumi Ishikawa's serves. We see long serves, sometimes fast and wide. This one into the backhand to start off the point. Now, usually a fast long serve into the backhand. The player's ready to turn and take the cross-court shot after.
7-all.
Shan Xiaona of Germany, women's doubles champion, with Patrice Asolia in the corner, bringing a bit of positivity for Feng Tianwei. Moral support, possibly advice here and there. That's the inside-out forehand that earns the chole and earns the point. Feng Tianwei used this many times yesterday. It was so effective, the angle she creates. Not only her reaction time and the efficiency of her strokes, how quick she is off the bounce, but the angles, the risks that she's willing to take, especially on that step around. As far as step rounds go, you just got to see another one from Kasumi Ishikawa. Typically, the left-handed player will play more step rounds. There's Miu Hirano with the wide collapse there in the crowd. Feng Tianwei yesterday beating Chun Su Yu from Taipei.
Nine,
well-placed half-long serve with some topspin. Feng Tianwei a bit handcuffed there on the receive. One more point to the third towel break. We'll see how much these players needed. It is the first game in a best of seven, but it feels quite intense. Oh, beautiful forehand right on the line. Miu Hirano approves. Hey, I'm on TV again. At a certain point, I mean, right now, she's just such a superstar in Japan, Miu Hirano. We'll see. Kasumi Ishikawa is quite famous in Japan as well, and there she is, the 2017 Asian champion, also the Women's World Cup winner from 2016. Me? This face? Is that who? Beautiful long serve wide to the forehand, and the follow-up attack, one game point saved by Feng Tianwei, a second serve to try and do the same. And by the same, I mean win the point.
9-10.
And she does it, another serve. This time it's half long. And Ishikawa stuck at the back of the table. A very difficult place if you're not able to get a loop to try and keep the ball short. Two big points, two game points saved for Feng Tianwei. Gotta love that facial expression from Ishikawa. Forehand flip deep into the backhand corner. Feng Tianwei fired up, takes game point here. Three in a row for Singapore's Feng Tianwei. Coach Mika Baba rooting on Ishikawa quietly. A quiet confidence. Back and forth, you could hear the sound of the ball, just the crack on these flat shots cross court. But it's Feng Tianwei who prevails, steals the game, 4 points in a row from down 8-10, and ends up winning at 12-10. What a way to do it. In fashion and ready to rock and roll, the top seed still in top position, up 1-0 against the second seed, Kasumi Ishikawa.
Stop that. Serve is okay, but 出す時にもうちょっと変化つけて、ちょっと弱気に出してるような。で、バック対バックから。スライディングショートショット、ショートセーブ。だから相手が、で、バックそんなに怖くない。焦りすぎ。うん、大したボール来てない。バックバックでも負けないけど、そっからフォアに1本。で、フォアみたいにフォアストレートとか入ったら、相手意識するから、回り込み。もし短いのだけだったら長いスタートミドル。で、頑張れ。
Didn't catch much. Katagambare, of course. Go for it. Keep fighting out here. Maybe a little bit about serving a little shorter. Bakando, the backhand. Use the backhand a bit. Try to get her into the backhand-to-backhand game, possibly. Apologize if my interpretations are wrong. For all the non-Japanese speakers out there, good opportunity for us to learn some Japanese here in the coaching corner.
Love one.
Forehand flip to start it off. to some of the initiative. You know, we saw Kasumi Ishikawa yesterday playing very well with that forehand flip. Once again, Feng Tianwei with that inside-out forehand, but you can hear that high cracking sound on the ball. A lot less spin than some of her other shots, and it's still bending away. Now Kasumi Ishikawa's got it. Stop! The speed in these rallies right now, both players are so fired up. We know that Feng Tianwei can handle it. She's beaten some of the top Chinese known for their short strokes, Liu Shiwen, for example. And it was Kasumi Ishikawa who was nominated for Point of the Year in 2015 at the Women's World Cup for playing Liu Shiwen the same way.
2-1.
A little bit off the edge, but that is a high quality shot. Not a ton of fortune still. Etiquette, courtesy of apologizing. Feng Tianwei playing risky to go around, play that right down the line.
Two, three.
Deep into the pocket. I'm sorry, the backhand corner, rather. I guess it is a pocket of its own. It's just not the middle, anyway. Look at the flip. Gets in. Nice open face of the racket, but wide. That exits the side of the table. Just to let you know, Kasumi Ishikawa started off beating teammate from Singapore, Zhou Yihan, this tournament. 4-1. After that, Sakura Mori. 4-1. There's the backhand to backhand. Taking the advice, playing it well. Yesterday, Kasumi Ishikawa beat Hina Hayata, who had an incredible backhand. Started off the match dominantly, winning game one with that backhand.
Four.
While the step around attack is Kasumi Ishikawa's bread and butter, I don't know if I'd call it a secret, but it's definitely her biggest weapon. Playing it to the short side of the table, it's gonna have a little bit less margin for error, maybe a little lower percentage shot. So dead even here in game two. How many times can Kasumi get the ball back on the table? I guess one less than Feng Tianwei here. But inside out forehand from Feng Tianwei. Kasumi's so good at reaching out and keeping her balance. A few defensive shots, tries to put a little more on it for the last one. Here we go, brings in Feng Tianwei, and while she's up on one foot, plays it deep to the other corner of the table to take advantage. In many sports, when someone leaves their feet, you know, in basketball, if someone jumps up to try and block a shot, it's very easy to draw the foul. Similarly here, when someone gets up on one foot or out of position, take advantage.
5-6.
Just to let you know, the end of the journey after beating Hina Hayata, Kasumi Ishikawa beat Miu Hirano yesterday to make it here to the women's singles final. Outstanding patience. Feng Tianwei hangs in there on the defense. But very focused and determined, Kasumi Ishikawa plays the angles and plays them powerfully. Look at this corner to corner. And one more wider. It's that step around bread and butter shot. A little bit of side spin on it to keep Feng Tianwei chasing the ball off the table. Second tall break of the game, and it's dead even again.
Yeah.
No question about the amount of blood flow right now and how much passion there is. I feel like from a score standpoint, there's a score to settle right now. Again, we're coming into the World Championships. It's the next major tournament on the World Tour. It's the next tournament on the World Tour. And the biggest tournament of the year, but with a backhand like that, Kasumi Ishikawa showing us that she's keeping her pencils sharpened. Her skills are on point right now. I mean, yesterday, to play so dominantly against Miu Hirano, a 4-0 shutout, winning 11-2 in game four. Another one similarly, if you didn't see Gao Ning versus Timo Boll, you'll have a chance to see Timo Boll later today. Gao Ning, you'll see more on YouTube at this point. Probably at the World Championships, but have to see. I'm not sure about that. Ishikawa right on top of the table, creating the angles. This is typically what Feng Tianwei does. Setting up the serve, setting up the third ball with the serve. That's a bit of a break for Ishikawa, but she keeps it deep on the table with topspin, kicking up and out. We got four game points. Two more than Ishikawa had in game one. Power on the forehand, the parallel shot, and the racket's down. She's off to the corner and ready for game three, tied up at one game each. A little conversation, a little hydration. And you can see the scores on screen. Overall, 18 points to 21. Feng Tianwei trailing in points. More just to think about the percentages and the balance right now. Again, a dominant performance. Not super dominant, but quite a confident performance from Feng Tianwei to get out of this one. I'm sorry, for Kasumi Ishikawa to get out of this one after Feng Tianwei came back in game one. Now, while Shan Xiao now talks to Feng Tianwei about her tactics in the short game, trying to deter Kasumi Ishikawa from opening up with the attacks. Tell you a little bit about how Feng Tianwei got here in the opening round. She beat Saki Shibata of Japan 4-0. After that, Korea's Jun Ji-hee. And that was a 4-0 victory as well. And finally losing a game to Minami Ando. It was a 4-1 victory, the first player of this tournament in any event that could beat Minami Ando, the medium pips backhander from Japan with the hard, flat-hitting forehand. And then Taipei's Chun Suyu, 4-2. Feng Tianwei ends up here in solid form, but has met her match, Kasumi Ishikawa, starting off game three with the serve. One, love. Receive over the table, Ishikawa, very strong. That looked like Yunam Kyu on the side, the Olympic gold medalist from 1988, a hero, a celebrity and a hero to Korea.
One, two.
Pretty new Cho sound, the echo effect from Feng Tianwei. If you want to impress any of your friends from Korea, assuming they've been alive for a little while, maybe into their 20s, say, hey, do you know Yunam Gyu? I love the fight in Feng Tianwei, both of these players. Very fired up from the start of this match. It's always interesting to see these rivalries. Sometimes I like to think when Feng Tianwei is 70, Kasumi Ishikawa is 64, are they gonna sit, drink some tea, and reminisce about the days in their rivalry? Will they keep in touch? Well, they might be friends off the table, There's no sign of it right now. It is a full-blown fight out here. Both players doing everything they can, not only to gain world ranking points, to take the title, not even just to prove to the other one how strong they are, that they can win, but to prove to themselves. I think that's what we heard before. It was Yo 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 from Kasumi Ishikawa following the Cho of Feng Tianwei.
Five, three.
Now remember, head to head, it's 9-5. Feng Tianwei having a winning record over Kasumi Ishikawa. For the first several years of their head-to-heads, Kasumi Ishikawa was quite young. Quick off the bounce play from Feng Tianwei, taking advantage of a ball coming up a little bit higher and having Ishikawa away from the table. And we think back to the fact that Kasumi Ishikawa started at 14 playing against Feng Tianwei, their first encounter. Think about Tomokazu Harimoto. He's played Ma Long already. Just missing long. Oh. Epic rally here. Again, the pace, the placement. It's just a full-blown pedal to the metal firepower on both sides. Backhand down the line. Feng Tianwei having to reach. Those last two forehands from Feng Tianwei had feet between them. And she plays them. She's just getting in position so quickly. Excellent receive from Ishikawa, steals the attack as the ball drifts off the table by mere centimeters. The open hand clap into the yoga pose and the face touch from Asian champion 2017 Miu Hirano. A lot of the sounds that come out of these players, people ask, what are they saying if they're newer to table tennis? What is Cho? What is Chole? Well, there are a lot of different explanations for this at the towel break. I think the release of air is often a big thing. When you get tense, much like on a roller coaster, if you're starting to feel sick, they say shout, scream, let it out. Don't trap the bad air inside. Similarly in sports. Excellent placement into the body from Ishikawa. Really is going back and forth here. Not the ball, but the score. I mean, the ball as well, of course. Much faster. Ishikawa with a little apology there. Little break. Not this time. This one doesn't come down. Beautiful forehand flip. Not a bad push. Good rotation on the ball from Ishikawa, but an even better read from Feng Tianwei. Feng Tianwei got everything back until finally the pressure from Ishikawa could seal the deal in this point. A few forehands from the backhand corner on the run. Makes one more backhand and finally just overshoots. See the frustration on the face of Feng Tianwei. Felt that that shot was very reasonable. Definitely agree for Feng Tianwei.
Chole! 8-9.
I think that's the loudest chole we've heard yet. Sometimes after missing a shot that you feel you should have made, coming back, sort of stamping your authority on the point, gives you the confidence you need, and you can hear it in the vocalization. adjustment early in the point, but it doesn't fool Ishikawa. Stays pinned in the backhand corner, opens it up wide. Brushing backhand first. Have to love how short those strokes are. The backhand, very little backswing. Watching Lushuan warm up at the table. Kasumi Ishikawa just the same. Very short circular motion on that backhand. Again, having to keep the racket head up and in a neutral position between every shot, just in case the ball goes somewhere you weren't expecting. Oh, this is the opportunity to go around the net. Feng Tianwei earning this third ball. Watch how hard she hits this, and Ishikawa gets it right back. But plays it right to the center of the net, tries to play a slightly safer shot, looping it up and over the net. Game point for Feng Tianwei. They seem to change the rhythm of the point. Smart play, Feng Tianwei, forcing Kasumi Ishikawa, or at least pressuring her to play a defensive shot, starting off the point slowly so Ishikawa couldn't get into the fast rally. 11-9, Feng Tianwei, up 2-1 over Kasumi Ishikawa.
ナックル来た時にそのボールをうまくタイミング合わせてバックドライブに回し、もし回り込みの3球目やるとしてバックストレートがうまく入らなかったらミドルとかフォアでもいいから、でチャンスボールのみバックを思いっきりバックストレートに行こう。サーブは今ので変化つけたりいいから、でバック長いサーブ出す時にストライクゾーンにだけ行かないようにサッと出てそのまま取れないようにフォアに行くボール
自分で注意しよう。Trying to catch some of that again. It's tough to know. You can hear some vocabulary words in there. Obviously, many words similar to English and Japanese. Serve, backhand, sabu, backhando, back straight. But it's tough to know what the message was completely. I think for Kasumi Ishikawa, opening with the backhand could be effective. We see a lot of players, Shushin especially, forehand dominant left-handed players, will open with the backhand and step around the corner.
Long one.
The combination tends to work well. But Ishikawa's also gonna have to sense where Feng Tianwei is gonna go. If she moves out to the forehand, Ishikawa's gonna have to play the short side, the backhand corner with her step around. Otherwise, the inside out ball will be tough for Feng Tianwei to reach. Solid start for the Japanese 24-year-old. There's that shovel serve that we see so much from many of the Japanese women. And also, of course, the top Chinese women. It might seem funny to say this because so far Ishikawa hasn't lost a point yet this game, but a serve that I haven't seen yet, but I can't recall seeing from Ishikawa. That high toss serve that kicks into the backhand side, but looks like it would have gone the other way. We got the high toss, but it's a traditional pendulum serve, long into the body. The streak continues to start off game four. Ishikawa's positioning is very solid when she gets into that backhand rally. Excellent read and lift as Feng Tianwei gets a heavy push. And backhand, no problem to spin it up for Feng Tianwei. Watch the contact. This is a little later in the rally. Didn't get to see that backspin shot. So backhand to forehand when playing the middle of Ishikawa. Feng Tianwei asserting herself, picking up the pace. Germany's Sean Xiaona in the corner there, supporting Feng Tianwei.
Four,
Cho and many more off the table to stay in this point and aggressive. Kasumi Ishikawa's positioning far better than Feng Tianwei's early on in this point. Look how close to the table she is. Feng Tianwei just running all around. But the angle she creates with that last backhand is quite a threat, and the sleeve is getting rolled up for Ishikawa. Little off the top of the net, the apology from Ishikawa as she steps back into a two-point lead. The crowd definitely getting their thrills here. In case you needed a reminder that this means a lot to both of these players. Both of these players I wouldn't be surprised to see on the World Tour Grand Finals at the end of the year. ITTF's World Tour is not only very exciting, but quite exhausting. A lot of the players playing several weeks in a row, not to mention league matches, training. National championships, continental games. Whoever wins this match will step way ahead in the race to the World Tour Grand Finals later this year. A little shallower on the table. You can see the bounce in slow motion there from Ishikawa's last shot. Changes the timing and the rhythm of the point. For example, that deep shot from Feng Tianwei races out into Kasumi Ishikawa, forcing the missed contact. How low that backhand is.
That's 6-5.
Ishikawa chasing there. Fortunately for her, Feng Tianwei's shot goes up and out. Still a two-point lead at the second towel break of the game. Ishikawa in the driver's seat. Power on the forehand. Ishikawa back up now 3 points, creating some puzzling facial expressions from Feng Tianwei. Can feel the shift in positioning though. Ishikawa a little bit more central, hasn't stepped around the backhand corner quite as much lately. Seems like this might have been a lot of the conversation with Coach Mika Baba about the backhand and how to use it, that you can give yourself more credit on the backhand side of the table. Feng Tianwei is too good with that inside-out forehand to give her that much space. And soft touch from Ishikawa, it's 5 game points. Heavy spin on the backhand and the arcing shot. The most dominant game yet this match. Ishikawa, when she wins, has won by 5 points and here by 6 points, where Feng Tianwei has won by 2 points each time. But again, they're not counting points at the end. It's whoever gets 4 games wins the match.
就这个球你注意点，像变成几个正手，这局护的挺好的，正手都有了。反手有几个球回来太狠了，你注意点，给你中间球，中间球尽量用正手，或者你要用反手可以，他给你中间，你不要从这儿再去往他正手位大脚边，这球不好变，对吧？这个球啊，这个球你一变好多球都下网，你就注意点。然后你发完短的，他拧你这个球，基本上在你这儿。 他等好你正手了，他发完短，你完这个球你可以给他偏反手中间一点，给他拧完给他个中间，然后再打两边，他好多等着你顶他正手的球。
自己摔细一点，短的短的这种球摔细一点。
A little bit there about Duan, a little bit short play about the different directions, of course the backhand. There's a lot of fun Joe in there. There's a lot of conversation about the backhand on both sides of the table. If Mika Baba's recommending backhand for Kasumi Ishikawa and Feng Tianwei's losing these rallies, it has to be addressed. Sean Xiaona advising, it seemed, Feng Tianwei to force the angles. Just the opposite happens. Creeps in for the backhand receive to the forehand side, and Ishikawa quickly races through the door down the line. Right now, the footwork is just so fast from Kasumi Ishikawa that even the angle changes that Feng Tianwei is bringing are not causing enough trouble to win her the point. Forced into defense, this is what she was talking about when Sean Xiaona was coaching, changing the angles, playing one wide and then one back down the line. We've seen a few points and some excellent points so far where Ishikawa's been forced into defense. But typically when that happens, Feng Tianwei is going to take the point. Oh, you don't see that too much. Risky serve to the length of the court. A right-handed player playing a left-handed player can do this. And Feng Tianwei going bold here. How fast and deep on the table that is. Even with all the footwork and speed of Kasumi Ishikawa, there's no telegraphing from Feng Tianwei that she's gonna do that. The delivery looks the same on the serve. Quality heavy spin shot from the backhand side. Ishikawa's been depending on that backhand. Last game winning 11-5. Recentering herself more on the table to use the backhand. Extra power, that grunt that you heard from Ishikawa when you get a ball that high. Again, it's still deep on the table with topspin. Puts enough pressure on Ishikawa. It's not easy to finish the point there. And it all started with that shot into the middle of Feng Tianwei, backing her off the table, getting her out of position. Speed rally from these two, both close to the table. Hearing the tick and the talk. Ishikawa, though, the one to walk the walk. Feng Tianwei trying so hard to find the middle so that she can open up the angle, but Ishikawa's very quick to cover the middle with the backhand right now. Again, this is the specialty of Feng Tianwei, that she can stay close to the table, play the short strokes and the wide angles. This time it works, going backhand to backhand down the line. A little bit of surprise for Ishikawa. One more shot deep to the backhand than she was expecting. It's a spinny opening backhand with a lot of power from Feng Tianwei. Every backhand in that rally from Feng Tianwei. Oh, service errors. Never a great time. But still a little bit of cushion. Although now it's two serves for Feng Tianwei, who you might recall nearly aced Kasumi Ishikawa with that wide serve to the forehand. Feng Tianwei takes both of these points. Suddenly, that 6-3 lead is gone.
Yeah. 4-7.
A little bit of extra spin from Ishikawa makes the ball jump up. timing for Feng Tianwei to go for those shots. That ball is so low when she goes for the backhand counter. Confidence and bold play from the Singaporean. Catching an edge right back on the top of Ishikawa's racket. Second towel break of the game. Deep in thought, Ishikawa figuring out her plan. Back in serve position, it appears that she has her plan. But sometimes you have a plan and then you see where the receiver is standing and something changes. Same for the receiver though. Sometimes the server will move a little bit more central on the table. You'll see Samsonov do that a lot, constantly moving around. The backhand to backhand rally, searching for the middle. The pressure builds up. Still a 1-point lead for Ishikawa on her second serve. Long with topspin has been effective for Ishikawa. If she can keep it a little bit on the shorter side of half long, it's often getting Feng Tianwei to play the push. So low to the net as you can see. Oh man, they just keep producing these rallies. And it goes back and forth for who will take them. They're both up to the task of the speed game. This is something that's relatively unique to the women's game. These very short stroke, fast counters close to the table. It can be quite thrilling, especially with the placement that both of these players have, running each other around. Feng Tianwei recovers, tied up. And there was a closed fist to the head from Ishikawa. Clever idea, but the ball comes up just a little bit. Could see that, the head back at the ceiling. Fortunately for Ishikawa, she has the serves here. Much better response. Feng Tianwei waits patiently this time, and instead of playing the push, has a little bit of room to get the topspin shot back from the back of the table. That's why Ishikawa's been trying to keep it a little bit on the shorter side of half long for a second bounce on the table. Ishikawa gets so much power on the forehand in this rally, recovers a ball that nearly hit her shirt. See some of the back and forth pace here. And it all started with the risky serve deep to the backhand. Last time I recall that serve, Ishikawa won the point. Spectacular play. Oh, to finish! Look at the angle! She was in the middle of the table when she hits this. This is one of the lowest percentage shots you could even imagine from that point. Her positioning on the court, I'd love to see a replay of that. Feng Tianwei, the way she's playing right now, is just one game away from taking the championship over Kasumi Ishikawa and getting her 10th head-to-head victory. Minor adjustments here. Kasumi Ishikawa talking to Coach Mika Baba. Sometimes that's all it takes. Again, the difference between your opponent having a backhand winner and being jammed in the middle could be just a few centimeters. A few of the shots in that point at 9-8 in the last game would have hit her in the shirt with a few centimeters difference. And Ishikawa comes out of the gates running, full steam ahead, takes the first point. Ishikawa turns the middle well, still doesn't bother Feng Tianwei in the blocking game. Stays in position on the backhand side, creates the angles. What a quality forehand flip, not an easy third ball. We see her trying to change a few things. Ishikawa, can't remember the last time I saw her serve high toss from the middle of the table, let alone serving from the middle of the table, period. And despite a slightly more passive final shot from Ishikawa, the change of rhythm and pace brings some trouble for Feng Tianwei. Differential now. Again for Feng Tianwei, this could be, well, I guess it could be the last game for both of them. Just Feng Tianwei would be the victor if it is the last game for both of them.
Three,
one thing I'd like to note, Ishikawa, even though that ball came up, if it comes down on the back of the table, she didn't start backing up immediately. She understands that she needs to stay close to be a threat, that if she backs off the table, Feng Tianwei is too crafty with the angles, too consistent. First two shots from Ishikawa in this rally as she calls the timeout. We're a bit off balance. She still managed to keep the ball in play, improvising with different spins. Quickly hydrating here.
だから自分の甘いボール、速く来たボールを素ばやくフォア行って。ボールがちょっとだけ甘いボールだったらサイド切れるから。で、フォア行くときに取られてるボールとかはちょっと内側に入ってるから、ちょっと取られてる。そこだけ気をつけよう。あと悪くない。 時々来る長いサーブだけ気をつけて、フォア前とかナックルとかっていうのをうまくレシーブ払ったり、ツッチキ入れたり、フォアを意識させて、ボールがだんだんバックに集まると相手の思うつぼになってるから。I
didn't catch a ton of that. Again, little adjustments. Talks about the receive. Rishibu, another word that's similar in Japanese as to the English receive. But yeah, as far as the backhand and the placement and playing the angles, it seems like this is sort of important for Ishikawa.
Three, four.
To get the angles with someone who's so quick and close to the table, finding the middle first and getting them off balance is the best way to create the opening on the table. Oh, and then there's that, the long serve and the rip with the inside out forehand. Beautiful shot to finish for Ishikawa. This is one fast point compared to some of the rallies that we've seen throughout. Look at the angle bending away still as it exits the side of the table. Yay, timeout worked. We've seen Coach Mika Baba with their hands in the air a lot in the last 2 weeks. Pressure again from Feng Tianwei, so quick on top of the table. Just thinking about with the microphones in the corners for the coaches, it's really a lot of pressure. Whole National Association watching, hearing every word you say to the player. There it is, this time Ishikawa's on top of the table and opens up to the forehand side, just pounces on that ball right off the bounce. She's got Feng Tianwei chasing a little bit after going corner to corner and finally getting the step around from Ishikawa. I mean, from Feng Tianwei, rather, leaves open the forehand side. Look at this angle again from the backhand. This is not the signature shot for Ishikawa. Her step around forehand finds that angle. If she can do it from that position with her backhand, Feng Tianwei has a lot to worry about. Probably something she didn't want to have to worry about and hasn't been prepared for in this match. Suddenly, Ishikawa becomes a bit more dangerous at the table. Nice receive, light spin. Open face of the racket, sort of a dead ball. Varying the spin on the pushes. Sometimes a flip with a little bit less rotation. Deep breaths here for Ishikawa. Breathing is actually quite important. Corner to corner, but still Ishikawa, when she earns the ball she wants, can't put it away. And you can understand her gritting her teeth and with the tongue out there. Between the breathing and trying to relax, this is one way to not frustrate yourself too much about missing such a good opportunity. But it is definitely coming down to the wire for Ishikawa. And I know I said breathing's important. Of course it is, in the sense that if you don't do it, you'll die. But more so just the fact that they can make sure that the muscles, the brain, gets all the oxygen it needs to stay loose and calm in such a tense situation. Again, back to dead even at 7 points each in game six. Deceptively heavy underspin on the pendulum serve. 1 point ahead, Ishikawa now. Feng Tianwei running around to get the forehand loop in, ties it back up. Well, we saw Ishikawa twiddling the racket there before the serve. Could be another little, almost like a mantra, but it's something that she does, a little mannerism to keep her cool in tense situations. But you were able to see the dark blue sponge on the forehand rubber. Looks a lot more like the Chinese setup.
Eight-old.
Wouldn't surprise me with all the Chinese practice partners and influence on the Japanese team. That's Feng Tianwei's specialty, the inside-out forehand. When she can get that into play, it's going to be difficult for Ishikawa. Just 2 points away from taking the title, Feng Tianwei with her second serve.
Yeah.
Ball drifts long. This is what happens when you give a lukewarm serve that comes off the table, but it's not intentionally deep. Third towel break of the game, and this could be going to a seventh, a final and deciding game. But the responsibility lies on the side of Japan's Kasumi Ishikawa with the serves. Down the line, I was so impressed from the start. The serve from Ishikawa, Feng Tianwei started to move to the forehand, and Ishikawa serves deep to the backhand, a risky serve, but the rally continues. And the pressure that Feng Tianwei puts on with that shot down the line earns her championship point. Serve comes too long, Feng Tianwei over Kasumi Ishikawa explodes with excitement here. What a match, 11-9 in game six. And Feng Tianwei with the apple do takes it, continues her streak over Kasumi Ishikawa. This is actually her first time beating Ishikawa in their her last three encounters after losing twice, sets the record straight. Her 10th victory on the world tour. Our women's singles champion is Singapore's Fong Tien Wei. And what a way to come into the world championships in Dusseldorf. Stick around, we've got the men's singles final. It should be an exciting one, a battle of generations for Germany. It's Patrick von Ziska and Timo Boll. Coming up right after this, you're watching the 2017 Seamaster ITTF World Tour Korea Open.